I've seen a lot of actors come and go. I've heard a lot of roars, but this is the loudest that I've heard.
I love you, Puneet. Thank you. And a special shout out to the team that made this video. This was truly special. Thank you. Thank you for your help.
Great. So let's get started. Let's.
Thank you, MPG. Thank you.
Going crazy.
Yeah.
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 Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, first of all, thank you so much for agreeing to do this. We have absolutely enraptured audience. Huh? We're all looking forward to this. They want to decode this enigma called Vicky Kaushal. It seems like a mysterious and yet such a draw that you have for especially the youngsters. It's something absolutely breathtaking. So the theme of the event is the stories we tell also tell us. So we want to know your story. Was it an unlikely one? I mean, could you take us back to your days of engineering and then how you journeyed, how it all started off? Because I know that it all started with an industrial event, if I'm not wrong. A lightning struck.
I would actually like to take the story a little further back.
Oh, lovely.
For 2 years of my life, I have stood at the bus stop right here. I was a Mithibai student. For 2 years of my life, I have stood at this bus stop. I was a science student, so my classes used to be from 7:30 to 1 o'clock in the afternoon. And I used to stand at the bus stop over here, wait for 79, 33, 38. These are the three buses that used to take me home. And I want to know, how much does the vada pav cost over here now?
30?
20? So when I was doing my junior college in Mithibai, this was 2001 to 2003.
By the way, when was the last time you had a vada pav?
Vada pav? I keep having vada pav on set. Yeah, I call for vada pavs. But in 2001 to 2003, I was in Mithibai. And that time, the vada pav used to be of 5 rupees. 5 rupees. When I went to 12th, it was 6 rupees because it was Amul Butter. And I remember, those days, I used to be given pocket money by my parents, and my pocket money was 600 rupees a month, which was 20 rupees a day.
Right.
So from Lokhandwala to here, 5 rupees busket ticket, 5 rupees busket ticket, 10 rupees, 5 rupees vada pav, and 5 rupees I used to save. So that 2 weeks later, Chandan mein picture lagni hai. Ya phir, picture nahi dekhni hai, to har dusre din phir main ek energy peeta tha. Energy milti hai abhi. Energy I used to love. So I've started from here,
right.
And then of course I did my engineering from Rajiv Gandhi Institute of Technology. Till that time, I'm still that guy, but I've always believed in living in the present, going with the flow, and just being completely honest to what I'm doing now. Yeah, jo bhi maze karne maze karta tha. That's it. कोई अगर पूछता था क्या करना है तो सब MBA कह रहे हैं तो मैं भी MBA कह देता था जब सब ने GRE कहना शुरू कर दिया मैं भी GRE कहने लग गया तो the plan was to do post graduation फिर देखते हैं कहाँ जाती है ज़िंदगी and I was good in studies but I was very active on stage since childhood but only subconsciously I loved doing that but तब तक मुझे लगता था it's just a hobby कि मुझे अच्छा लगता है being on stage performing for an audience but never really thought that I want to make it a career choice. So when I was doing my engineering in the second year, the college faculty took us to an industrial visit to show us ki bachon, this is your future. You know, when you pass out, you complete your graduation, this is how an MNC looks, this is how the work, whatever, the floor looks and how people work. And that was that one day that I felt something so purely in my life for the first time that my andar ghusa, I'm like, this is not for me.
Exactly
not for me. Yeah, tuk, 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 is not for me. Academics is supporting, the way I'm functioning in my exams, it's supporting. I can't connect. This is not me. And that was the first time I thought, Vicky, what now? What do you want to do? Because there's no point doing post-graduation in the same field if you don't want to eventually come to this chair. So that was the first time I started introspecting as to what do you want to do. So I was thinking, achha, yahan mujhe nahi jana because this is something that I feel I won't enjoy, I won't be happy doing, I won't be self-motivated to do. Then what is it that I really enjoy doing? So the answer was performing for the audience. And that was the first time I thought, ki yaar, actor, and I still remember that moment when I was looking into the mirror and I said and then I looked at myself from top to bottom and I'm like and then I'm like, but choice nahi hai. And I'm like, chal dekhte hain. And then, but the thing was, the rule was in the family that first you have to finish graduation, you have to finish it well.
And engineering,
and,
especially.
And engineering. Or up to ghus chuke
the, there's a joke about engineering. Like, it's like a public toilet. No offense to the engineers.
Public what?
Public toilet. Because when you're out, you're dying to get in. But when you're in, you're dying to get out.
Aisa nahi hai.
That's like, even I'm an engineering
dropout.
So.
Actually, to be honest, I really had a ball of a time doing engineering.
Oh.
Yeah. Kal ko mere bachche pata nahi kya karenge, par main engineering mein zarur dalunga. Because I have found the best of my friends over there, and main tab tak na, till my engineering, I was a very shy, coy boy, jo, matlab, he was not street smart, he was just bechara. Engineering ne jo mere andar ka mard jagaya hai. Kyunki engineering mein to, it's like, it teaches you. All that scrutiny and assignments and projects and all of that teaches you a lot more than just education. It really teaches you the grind. So I had a blast doing my engineering. I finished that, and then in 2009 is when I started my journey as an actor.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's how it all began. As audience, we always like to look at the glory days of an actor, of how he's doing well and all the success and fanfare that he's enjoying. But failures is something that we don't talk about. Like, everyone has a good share of it. Was it a straightforward journey? Because if I'm not wrong, you start off with assisting Anurag in the...
It started in 2009, where my first step towards this profession of acting was that I wanted to be really sure that it's more than a hobby.
Okay.
That every day when I wake up in the morning, I really want to act. Mm-hmm. That's all that I want to do after waking up in the morning. So I joined an acting institute in Bombay. This was a 6-month program where, of course, I wanted to learn acting. Of course, I wanted to learn the skills. But more than that, I just wanted to be sure that if I'm made to act every day, am I a happier soul or am I cribbing about it? That's what I really wanted to know. So I did that, and by the end of it, I got my answer that I really, really love doing this. After that, I was also sure, I remember I was 22 back then, right after engineering, I was 22. I was in no hurry to be in front of the camera.
Right.
Because I knew that, firstly, camera captures everything. You're a good actor, bad actor, fantastic actor, worst actor. It will present you the way you are, because in acting, your eyes have to be honest, and the camera captures everything. The audience, in 2 seconds, of sitting in that cinema hall, in that first shot you give, in that first scene that you do, they know that if you can act or not. And once they've made that judgment that then it's a very uphill task to really prove your worth to the audience. So I wanted to do all of that before actually coming to the audience.
Very patient.
So I had kept 5 years in my mind that kam se kam main 5 saal dunga to study this, to learn the tropes, to meet people, learn from them, assist them, do backstage in theatre, do everything that is related to cinema and acting, learn all that I can before I'm fairly even confident to face the camera and come in front of the audience. So it's very strange, because when I was doing that acting course in 2009, I still remember the date was 24th of July 2009, and it was the first day of my acting course, and the teacher, it was a class of 20 students, and they just randomly asked, like, you know, okay, how have your last five years been like, and we were all discussing that, and then they asked that, how do you want your next 5 years to be like, and where do you see yourself in the next 5 years? And I really am not a big fan of this question, because I don't know what I'm going to do in the next 5 minutes, and I really don't want to know where I'm going to be. Sometimes where you think you're going to be in the next 5 years is much smaller than what God has planned for you. So I don't want to limit myself in that thought process. But still, but I was asked that question, and just because it was the first day of the class, and I didn't want to say that I don't like that question, because I thought that they might just throw me out of the school. So I just answered that, sir, 5 saal lagenge ya 6 saal lagenge, you'll see my poster. In front of a cinema. I just said that with all belief, ki 5-6 saal lagenge, I'll do theater, I'll assist somebody, I'll do behind the scene work and I'll be there. This was 24 July 2009 and 24th July 2015 was the day when Masaan released and my poster was there. And it's just, sometimes things like these make me believe in belief that, you know, ki you just have to sometimes just give it out there. Just give it out and do it. Like, you know, sometimes it's not necessary for you to know how it's going to happen. But it's very necessary for you to believe that it's going to happen. If you believe that it's going to happen is when the how takes care of itself. So, I mean, you guys are going to start and do whatever you want to do in life, but never lose that belief. That's step one. Before skill, before talent, before everything else, that's step one.
Great, that's
and I also want to give a disclaimer that I tend to forget my questions and I go on a different trip. So just get me back whenever you feel
that. What about the failure part? Which
failure. Failure ki to baat hi nahi ki pravachan dene lag gaya. Failure, yes. I saw.
So that is very important because when you look at the youngsters,
of course,
they are very bad at accepting rejection. And failure is something that rattles them.
Yeah.
So I think it's equally important.
Aur phir baad mein ek list di jati hai ki aap apna naam likho, number likho. और फिर वो लिस्ट में जब आपका नंबर आएगा तब आपको अंदर बुलाया जाएगा फिर एक डेढ़ घंटा वेट करने के बाद आपको अंदर बुलाया जाता है फिर आप देखते हो कि 200 और ग्लैडराइज के मॉडल अंदर है और फिर एक कैमरा होता है एक कास्टिंग डायरेक्टर होता है एंड देन ही और एक स्क्रिप्ट दी जाती है आपको कि ये फलाना फलाना 5-10 लाइन बोलना है एंड यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर देन देन एंड देयर कि आप प्रिपेयर कीजिए और वहाँ पर आप बोलिए और व्हाइल यू आर वेटिंग ऑल दोज 100 पीपल आर डूइंग देयर परफॉर्मेंसेस And wahan baithe baithe you realize so much ki where you stand. Because some come which really raise your confidence because you're like, which is the better you want. And some come which you are like, yeah, main nikalta hu yahan to nahi hoga, ye kya tha, isne to mujhe rula diya. So every day, so that giving 8 to 10 auditions every day and going through this process really like, you know, आपको अपना लेवल बता देता है एंड समटाइम्स व्हाट हैपेंस इज मैं एड्स के ऑडिशंस बहुत देता था फिल्म्स के भी बट समटाइम्स यू गेट सिलेक्टेड इन द टॉप 3 देन यू लाइक यस 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 फिर आपको फोन आता है कि सर आपका बजट क्या है आप टॉप 3 में आ चुके हो कल पीपीएम है हमारी फिर डायरेक्टर्स प्रोड्यूसर्स के साथ बात होगी फिर हम सिलेक्ट करेंगे देन यू गिव योर बजट एंड देन यू आर वेटिंग फॉर दैट कॉल एंड देन वो कॉल करके बताते हैं कि सर आप सिलेक्ट नहीं हुए लाइक अरे यार And then you give auditions and then you select and get selected again and फिर नहीं होता फिर मुझे लगा शायद यार बजट की वजह से तो नहीं हो रहा कि देन फिर मैं सिलेक्ट होने लग गया फिर वो कहता कि सारा बजट बताओ मैंने कहा सर आप बजट बताओ आप बताओ मैं उसमें भी रेडी हूँ आप मुझे काम दो आप फिर उसमें भी नहीं होने लग गया तो एटलीस्ट मुझे लगा बजट की वजह से नहीं है जो भी क्राइटेरियाज है बट द इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग इज टू जस्ट कीप गोइंग यू नो टू जस्ट कीप गोइंग आई हैव ओनली टिल अबाउट उरी एंड मनमर्जिया हैव बीन द ओनली टू फिल्म्स दैट आई हैव नॉट गिवन अ स्क्रीन टेस्ट फॉर आई जस्ट गॉट picked up by the director ki nahi tu hi karega ye role otherwise every other film be it Razi Sanju Masaan Raman Raghav Love Per Square Foot if Zuban my first break every other film I got it through a screen test so these are I could count the number of films on my fingers but I have given at least 1000 to 2000 to 3000 auditions I have given at least those auditions. And then out of them, I have got 8 films. So the failure rate is much higher, much, much higher. But the important thing is to just keep walking, just keep walking, just keep walking, just keep walking. Yeah.
Once you did Masaan, you were noticed. And then you went on to other films. But Which film was exactly the turning point you thought that this has really made my presence and...
Uri!
I think much later, right? Even before that, you thought there was a...
Abu! Sanjo!
Do you agree? I think I should ask that.
Sanjo!
As an actor, it's the most beautiful feeling when you as an audience are naming so many films as my turning point. It's the most beautiful feeling. But see, Masaan was the first film that came out. See, Zubaan, actually the film that came out after that, which not many people came to know of it, but that was the first audition for the lead role that I had cracked and the first film that I had shot for. And then I shot for Masaan, but Masaan came out first. But Masaan was the first work that people saw of mine, and it really gave me a lot of credibility because the film got a lot of credibility. It opened a lot of doors in the industry for me. But after Masaan, for the longest time, I was, Masaan ka hero. That Masaan guy. But the past 1 year with films like Razi, Sanju, Man Marzi, and then of course, Uri just changed everything for me. But then, pichle ek saal se Vicky Kaushal zyada sunai deta hai. That, you know, they know my name. But all these films, in some way or the other, have turned something in my life. For the good.
Right, great. You also mentioned Raman Raghav. Now that is a very under-celebrated yet a very powerful film that a lot of people really admire. Especially the character that you played was intense and had shades of. Was there a particular process or with respect to preparation that you went through? Because we got to know that you sort of tried to isolate yourself and tried a lot to get into the character. So. What kind of acting do you subscribe to? Do you believe in that there is something called as a classical acting style, there is method acting, or do you think it's just these distinctions don't really
I don't point? Really believe in one approach towards acting, because I feel at the end of the day, between action and cut, I have to be honest.
Correct.
That route could be anything.
Right.
Anything.
Right.
Main chahe ek din pehle kitna bhi Stanislavski ki padh lu, but between action and cut, if I'm not feeling it, I'm not feeling it.
Correct.
You know? So My goal is to reach that honestly, no matter how I reach there. Different films, different characters, depending on how far or near that character is to you, you decide on your route. That, acha, what you need to do. Acha, isme mujhe ye karna hai. So, like the example you picked up, Raman Raghav, that character was really far away from me. Really far away in terms of emotions. Mm-hmm. Like Masaan was geographically very far away. Ki mujhe lehza nahi aata. Wo kaise baat karte hain? Wahan ke wo jo dome community hai, jo wo kaam karti hai, unka kya taur tareeka hota hai. To mujhe wo adapt karna tha. But for Raman Raghav, I had to adapt the emotional state of mind, which was very difficult for me. So when Anurag sir had called me up that, you know, ki main aise ek film bana raha hu serial killer aur cop pe. I wanted to play the cop, but I don't think you can really play him because he's a very edgy, disturbed character, and he knows my family, he knows my upbringing, and he's like, you've had a very secure upbringing, so I don't know if you're going to be able to understand that. I was like, sir, let me give a screen test, let's see. I don't know what your film is all about, but let me just give a screen test. It'll be at least a good exercise for me as an actor to explore it. So for 5 days, I told him, so he said, ki kitne din chahiye mujhe? Maine kaha, mujhe 5 din de dijiye, and then I'll come to your office after 5 days. So I thought that if it's something so far away from me, let me try this tool of isolation. Let me physically separate myself from my friends and my family, from my comfort space. Let me live somewhere and just disconnect. So for 5 days, I was living in another house that I have where there were no newspapers, no TV, no phone. I was not stepping out of the house. I was not communicating with anyone. 5 days, I've stayed quiet. Just not talk. So, and I used to step out only once in the day, which was at 4 a.m. Which was at 4 a.m. late in the night when the world outside is sleeping.
Correct.
So, and I wanted to know what's happening to me. If I'm becoming edgier, if I'm being irritated, if it reminds me of the darkness inside, past, whatever. I didn't know what's going to happen. So for the first day, I was really bored. Second day, I was maha bored. Third day, I was like, I really need to talk to somebody. Fourth day, I started getting really irritated. Fifth day, I wanted to kill Anurag Kashyap. And then fifth day, after leaving from there, I straight went to Mukesh Chawla's office, who was the casting director. And I gave that screen test, and I was very happy. And I remember this was sometime around September, because after that, I had to go to my building where we keep Deir Din Ka Ganpati. So it was around Ganpati. So I was very happy. Ki, yaar, achanak se, ab main 100 logon se milunga. I was very... Sabko gale lagane ka mandara. So I gave the audition and I got a call from Anurag sir that I've seen the audition, come back. I was like, achha. Then I went back and the first thing he said was, ki, jo bhi tune kiya hai, जो भी तूने वो सीन परफॉर्म किया है दैट्स एग्जैक्टली व्हाट आई डोंट वांट एंड फेलियर एंड देन आई वाज लाइक ओके रोल गया तो बट देन ही इज लाइक बट आई एम लॉकिंग यू फॉर द पार्ट एंड लाइक हां एंड देन ही इज लाइक नहीं आई कुड सी समथिंग इन योर आईज बट आई विल टेक यू देयर I could see the character, but we'll have to do a process. But then there was a process, and we did the film. And the process was eventually when we started. The process was it was just a 21 day shoot. 21 days straight we finished the film. Day in day out we were shooting. Most of them were nights. Irritating scenes. Very I had to beat up women and do drugs and this and that. It was a very dark film. So I told my parents not to talk to me. I stay with my family. And usually what happens is whenever I come back from shoot, my mom being Mom, she's like, "Beta, kaisa raha shoot and this and that." Be it 4 a.m., 6 a.m., 10 p.m., whatever the time is, she'll sit with me and ask me about the day. So I asked her, "Ki ye mat karna mere saath. I'm gonna just quietly come, sleep, eat, go. 20 din, sirf don't talk to me." That was there, and the other process was that I used to listen. Music sometimes helps you. So music was also a tool for me. I used to listen to a lot of Skrillex songs. I don't know. Okay. But Skrillex is a lot of like a trap music and before giving the shot I remember we were shooting in Anurag sir's house so I was used to go into the bathroom and I used to put my headphones on and listen to some Skrillex songs and I used to rage in the bathroom I used to rage like talk to myself scream rage and everything and then come out and then do the scene and then I remember and Anurag Kashyap being Anurag Kashyap he's got the tendency of giving you 4 pages का सीन कि कल करते हैं and हाँ कल करते हैं ये 4 pages तो बोलेगा and then so I there was a scene like that where I had to just talk to a camera it got deleted from the film that he put it on YouTube much later so there's a deleted scene on YouTube if you want to check from Raman Raga where it's just 6 pages 6 minutes monologue which I'm talking to a handicap that's it so that and it's a scene where he's almost going to commit suicide But he decides, he's got his angst against his father and he decides that let me just record it on a handycam first and then I'll shoot myself. Okay. So it was a very heavy scene. That I remember, I used to do the scene, I used to, coming back from the shoot, I used to step out from my building at about 2 o'clock, 2:30 in the night and I used to take rounds, I used to walk on the streets and I used to just say those lines. Not emoted, nothing because I didn't want to feel it much earlier on before doing that scene because I don't think a moment like this where you feel suicidal where you feel like almost coming killing yourself comes very often to you so I didn't want to feel it every day I wanted to feel it for the take but I just wanted to be very fluent with the lines so I would just take rounds and I would just talk I would just say these lines I would just say these lines for like 1 hour ka walk pe I'll go and then come back home and go to sleep and then we did that scene so there were like different methods and approaches but the fun Trivia about Raman Raghav is and why I'll remember this film for the rest of my life is because when the time came when the film was shown and there was a screening and of course my family goes for every screening, they watch the film. This was one screening I was very scared because I'm not doing nice things in the film. Anurag Kashyap had shot me naked in the film. I'm doing drugs, I'm beating a woman. So I was very, and I told my mom, don't ask me anything. So my mom was very excited. अरे अरे आज पिक्चर देखने जा रहे हैं बेटे की पिक्चर देखने जा रहे हैं लाइक माँ आप जाओ मैं देख चुका हूँ आप जाओ बिकॉज आई कुडंट सिट नेक्स्ट टू हर एंड वॉच दैट एंड सो अरे ऐसे कैसे नहीं नहीं चलना पड़ेगा चलो मैंने कहा चलो फिर देन वी वेंट एंड मॉम वाज सिटिंग एंड देन आई लाइक मॉम मैं जरा 3 रो पीछे बैठता हूँ मैं जरा अपनी टीम के साथ बैठता हूँ हाँ हाँ बेटा मूवी स्टार्ट्स मूवी इज गोइंग ऑन मॉम इज वॉचिंग द फिल्म आई एम वॉचिंग मॉम एंड आई एम लाइक एक चप्पल ऐसे पीछे उड़ती हुई आने वाली है या फिर मॉम उठते ही निकल जाएंगे और मुझे डिसोन करने वाली है तो आई एम जस्ट वॉचिंग हर